Some skills are hard to learn because you can't break them apart into smaller pieces. A skill like brewing a cup of tea involves a discrete set of steps that can each be practiced alone. Pick up the kettle, pour the water, put the kettle down. You could practice each part separately and then put them together without too much difficulty. But many skills involve interdependent parts. Playing StarCraft, for instance, involves a bunch of different skills that all depend on each other. You have to collect resources, build buildings and units, scout your opponent, attack, defend, retreat, and overall respond organically to what your opponent is doing. Your overall skill level depends on the interaction of all these different component skills, but you can't really practice them separately either. So how do you get practice at a highly interdependent skill like this? There are many ways you might go about it, but a very simple and effective way is just to change what you pay attention to. An old study on a video game that I guarantee you have never played before called Space Fortress illustrates this idea pretty well. Not this one. Not this one. That's the one. Space Fortress, like StarCraft, involves a lot of interacting parts. The researchers split learners into four different groups. Now, the control group played the game for about 6.5 hours over the course of 10 different practice sessions. The other three groups played the game for the same amount of time over the same number of sessions, but the researchers gave some special instructions to these groups. Researchers instructed group two to pay attention to the ship controls over the first 6 sessions. And the last 4 sessions, they just played the game just like the control did. Controlling the ship is pretty critical to doing well in the game. Researchers told group three to pay attention to the placement of mines around their ship. Mine placement is also apparently another important aspect of doing well at the game. And the fourth group was instructed to pay attention to ship control for the first 3 sessions, mine placement for the next 3 sessions, and then, like the other groups, the last 4 sessions are the same as the control. They're not told to pay attention to anything in particular. Notice that if you were just to look at this from the outside, every group seems to be doing the exact same thing for the same amount of time. The only difference is what the groups are paying attention to. In the beginning, the group started out basically the same, but over time, as the power of attention began to take hold, group differences started to emerge. After 6 sessions, the control group, which had just played the game but didn't have any particular instructions about what to pay attention to, they were scoring about 1,000 points. The two groups who had focused on one aspect of the game for those first 6 sessions were scoring about 1,500 points per game. And the fourth group, who had focused on 2 different aspects of the game during those first 6 sessions, was scoring about 2,000 points per game. After that, all groups continued to play the game like normal for the next 4 sessions. But that didn't stop group 4. They continued to learn more than groups 1, 2, and 3 over the next 4 sessions. This is a finding that has been replicated in various other contexts as well. Paying attention to just one aspect of the skill helps our brain to create meaningful building blocks for the more complex skill. We can pay less attention to the other parts, build the pieces we need, and then integrate them together over time. So the next time you are faced with learning a complex interdependent skill, try this method out. Just pay attention to one aspect of the skill for a little while, then pay attention to another aspect of the skill, then maybe another aspect of the skill, then come back to that original thing that you worked on again. I'm willing to bet that you would get greater learning gains that way than if you were to just practice while trying to pay attention to everything equally all at once. For more on how attention influences learning, I've got this lovely video right over here for you. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.